Hi guys, welcome to my channel Subha Sir's Classes. Today we are going to start the new chapter after the completion of the first one. We are going to structure of the atom for class 11. And in this chapter, we have to discuss starting from Dalton's atomic theory, Michaels Faraday's experiment with electrochemistry, and the Thomson's atom model and its failure. But the Thomson's experiment with cathode ray discharge tube up to the characteristics of cathode rays. So first of all, let us start the chapter. You know John Dalton and his atomic theory, popularly known as Dalton's atomic theory. That theory had discussed about the indivisibility of atom, means atoms are not divisible at all. But later on, the subatomic particles like electrons, protons and neutrons were discovered. So when these subatomic particles were discovered, clearly atom was divisible, so Dalton's atomic theory had to be modified. And after that, there was different atom models. When the atom was divisible, when there were chances of subatomic particles, different scientists tried to sketch the model of an atom, giving different atom models. Some of them were Thomson's atom model, given by J.J. Thomson. Next was Rutherford's atom model, and the last one was Niels Bohr's atom model, which was most popular, and what was also the latest one. So what did these atom models give us? The atom models gave us some explanations how the internal structure of atom might be, how would be the center of the atom, what would be the nature of the nucleus, what would be the nature, the placement, the position and the design of the protons and electrons inside an atom. Thomson's model was discarded because he had a plum pudding model in which he thought that the protons and electrons are like plum and pudding inside. So it was a wrong idea because the opposite charges cannot reside together at a very close distance, they would cancel each other. So plum pudding model was cancelled, it was discarded by the next scientists. But Thomson gave a new discovery. His step towards this experiment paved a new way up to quantum mechanics, up to quantum theory. So what did he give to the mankind? He gave the experiment which is known as cathode ray discharge tube, in which he used a, say, a glass tube having a facility of pumping the gas outside so that the gas inside can be vacated. He placed two electrodes, means electricity carrying electrodes, and he connected it to a very high voltage, when say greater than 10k. He had a high voltage, there was a cathode, there was an anode, see, this is minus, this is plus, there was an anode and there was a cathode, and there is a pump set connected to this. He inserted a gas inside and he evacuated the gas to such an extent that the pressure factor became almost 1/300 atmospheric pressure. When there is a very low pressure and very high voltage, so what did he employ? In the discharge, this is the cathode ray discharge tube. What he did is, he took two oppositely charged electrodes, one is anode, the other is cathode, and he connected the two ends to a very high voltage of the order 10,000 volts, and he had the pump set connected to it so that the gas can be evacuated to reduce to minimize the pressure up to 1 by 300 atmosphere pressure so that at this very low pressure and very high voltage he saw a tremendous new result, a cute result came. There was a glow here. That means as if a ray was coming from this cathode towards the anode. And he named this ray to be cathode ray. Because these rays emerged from the cathode, their name was cathode rays. And these cathode rays traveled from this to that, from the cathode to the anode. And how did he know? These rays could not be seen in the naked eye directly, but when this glass piece was covered with some crystals, there was a dazzling color here. So he understood that a ray has come up to this. He named this cathode rays and he tried to find out different characteristics. Characteristics of cathode rays. We can count at least 9 to 10 characteristics of cathode rays. From this experiment, he found that these rays have reached this and they are in straight line. So, cathode rays travel in straight line, the first point. These rays travel very fast at the speed of nearly at the speed of light and in a straight line, the first point. This and they travel from the negatively charged cathode towards the anode. This is the second point. They travel from cathode to anode, so they are named as cathode rays. They travel in straight lines and they have some material particles. They have some material particles. Why? When he placed a circular object like this and in a string, he saw that it is rotating, means something is hitting, so that it is rotating. So he found that some material thing is going also with the ray. The ray is not a blank one, it is carrying some matter. So the third factor was a matter. Next, when he placed say a positively charged, highly positive charge here and highly negative charge here, means electrostatic field. When he placed some electrostatic field, he saw a different change. These rays were deviated from their straight line movement towards the positive charge. So, what does that mean? That means these rays contain some negatively charged particles. So, he found negatively charged particles inside these rays. So, that was the fourth observation. There was a fifth observation. When he placed some metals here, this ray had some heating effect. So, there is a heating effect. There was the metals were heated. So, when cathode rays fall on metallic plates, they heat them. This was found. And when they stroke, he allowed them to strike on metals like tungsten or molybdenum, he found that a new ray is coming outside. When cathode rays strike, the new ray was found to be X-ray. So, the cathode rays have the capability of producing X-rays when they fall on certain metals like tungsten or molybdenum. And the next property was a fluorescence property. When zinc sulfide, material like zinc sulfide, a crystal or a zinc sulfide crystal or a zinc sulfide plate was kept here, it was found that a green fluorescent lights, there is a fluorescence due to this. So, they can produce green fluorescence on zinc sulfide. And there is another thing, they had a effect when these rays were put on silver bromide plates or photographic plates, they blackened it, means they have photographic effect. They can just blacken the photographic plate, means they have effect on photographic plate. The next property was, there was a penetrating effect. If you place very thin, say 0.3 mm aluminium foil, cathode ray is coming, and you place a aluminium foil of say 1 mm thick, then it will pass through it, means it has a penetrating effect. And out after all these, there is a special property, special characteristic found, which led the experiment towards our modern physics era, and that was the E by M ratio. This is the special thing. What is E by M ratio? E is charge on electron. You know that charge on electron is -1.6 × 10⁻¹⁹ coulomb. And mass of the electron, which was yet to be found, now we know it, it is 9.11 × 10⁻³¹ kg. From this experiment, he found the E by M value, which was 1.76 × 10⁻¹⁰ coulomb per kg. So, when he found this value and put it here, E divided by E by M, gave him M, and this value could be found. You can clearly calculate this 1.6 × 10⁻¹⁹ divided by M ratio 9.11 × 10 or divided by E by M ratio 1.76 × 10⁻¹⁰. Then you get this one 9.11 × 10⁻³¹ kg. So, this was E by M ratio. This was the most important development which emerged out of the cathode ray discharge tube experiment, and that actually gave us a huge blow, a huge turn, a huge sweep towards going to modern physics era. So, with this we conclude this class, and in this class we talked about the structure of the atom, how the experiment put us here in the modern world, and how the cathode ray discharge tube brought about those characteristics which led to further experiments in the line. In the next class, we are going to study about the alpha rays. These cathode rays are also known as beta rays, and the charged particles it contained were found to be electrons. So, in the next discharge tube, we shall talk about anode discharge tube. In the same discharge tube, what was the change given so that the anode rays could be discovered, and we shall also count the different characteristics of anode rays. So, till the next class, let us end this chapter. Thank you for watching. Bye.